and a deserving actress.
Let me start by...
Today we live in a continent where many people misunderstand the role and function of legislators. We live in a continent where legislators are measured by the number of funerals that they attend, where the efficacy of legislators is measured by the number of weddings they attend, where their significance is measured by the number of men and women that they support on the day of their weddings. And therefore, we live in a continent where the legislator is misunderstood. We live in a continent where legislators are not called and expected to perform their traditional functions. And that is why the launch of a magazine such as this speaks to the demands of a nation such as Nigeria, and I dare say many African countries. I cannot remember, but I know that there is an African saying that as long as lions do not have their historians, it is the exploit of the hunter rather than the bravery of the lion that will be talked about. Today, you have decided to tell your own story that you may not be misunderstood. You know, when in the 1960s there was an explosion of independence, we were handed down, and in many ways, many institutions were imposed on us. We were told that African countries, having regained their independence, had to embrace democracy. And we were told, borrowing once again from the definition of other civilization, that democracy is a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. And we were told at the time of regaining our independence that we would have representative democracy. We were told then that you honorable members of the House of Representatives represented us. We were told then that you are our servants. And for a long time, we believed that you are our servants. But over the years, things did change. And we started believing that you are no longer our servants, and that you had become our masters. And that therefore, even when you claim to represent us in many African countries and you remind us that you are our servants, we do not believe you, because it is the newspapers that are left to say what you say, because it is the televisions and the newscasters that are told and are allowed in their jaundiced way to tell us what you represent. It gladdens my heart that in Nigeria, through the efforts of Honorable Baje Abiamila, you have taken the decision to renew your contract with the people of Nigeria. You have decided to create, or if you may, to recreate the umbilical cord that will link you with the people of Nigeria. Because in Nigeria, as in many countries, people are asking, why is it that the things that we expected of our leaders have not been delivered? When you listen to Nigerians, both here and abroad, they are asking of their legislators, what are you doing? They are asking of their legislators, where are the promises that you made to us when we regained our independence? And the only way to answer them is through the medium of a publication such as this, so that the information that they receive is information that they are, that is not mediated. Nigerians, both here and abroad, are asking, you legislators who are our representatives, what have you done over the years? They are asking, when we regained our independence, you promised that there would be no unemployment. And they are asking, what have you done about unemployment? What have you done about appropriate legislation in that area? You may have done something about it, but they do not know because you never told them. They are asking, what did you do about education? You promised that we would have free education. You may have said something about it in the many pieces of legislation that you have enacted, but they do not know because the little that they hear is through the newspapers, whose memories are sometimes selective and jaundiced in order to paint a picture which is so not very rosy. They are asking, you promised that you would provide us with free health, and perhaps you may have enacted legislation, but they do not know, because what they hear are hostels that are not functioning as they should. But this time round, through the magazine that will be launched shortly, you'll be able in an unmediated way to tell them what it is that they have done. They are asking, what have you done about the extractive industry? And they cannot understand what it is that they have done. But I hope and pray that through this magazine, you'll be able to speak to them directly. Nigerians, both home and abroad, are asking, in the year 2090, you had a vision 2020, and you promised that Nigeria would be one of the 20 largest economies in the world and one of the most influential nations on earth. They are asking, what have you done through legislation to ensure that Vision 2020 is realized? They are possibly asking, is it another mirage? Through this publication, you'll be able to tell them what it is that you have done. The Nigerians, both home and abroad, may be asking, that last year, in the year 2019, you promised that you'd have a new currency. They are asking, that currency that you promised them in 2020, is it coming? And if it is coming, what is the legislation that you put together to ensure that that currency is alive and well? Perhaps you have done something about it, but Nigerians do not know. We are here and we know that Nigeria is a good citizen of the world. They know, Nigerians young and old, that Nigeria was present in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, when we came up with Agenda 2063, and they are asking us, Big Brother Nigeria, what it is that you are doing in order to ensure that Agenda 2063 is realized. Perhaps you have done something about it in your legislation, but we do not know. But I hope that through this magazine, you'll be able to speak to Nigeria directly and in a manner that is unmediated. Nigerians, both home and abroad, are asking that there is the Africa Continental Free Trade Area with its secretariats in Ghana. They are asking, what is the piece of legislation that you have enacted to ensure that that is realized? Perhaps you have done something about it, but they do not know. But I hope that through this magazine, that ghost of ignorance, which has not allowed Nigeria to appreciate and to embrace their leaders, will now be exorcised. I hope that that ghost will be consigned to Jehanam so that it will not rise again, so that going forward, Nigerians will understand their leaders for who they are. I remember, as a young man, I read a book that was written in 1955. That book was written by an African-American, Carter G. Woodson. That book was entitled Miseducation of the Negro. And in that book, Carter G. Woodson poses the question, who is a leader? He poses the question, is a leader one who has monopoly of wisdom and knowledge? Is a leader one who knows everything? But he answers that rhetorical question in this way. He says he or she is a leader, not necessarily because he knows more than the people he leads, but because he's brave enough to offer himself or herself. He is a leader not because the people whom he leads are walking on the ground and he or she is riding a horse? No. He is a leader because he is ready to go to the front. He is a leader because he or she is prepared to deny himself for the general good. How do I understand the Green Magazine? I understand the Green Magazine initiated by the Honorable Femi Bajabiamila as a document which is designed and dedicated to tell Nigerians that the time has come for your leaders to walk together with you, not because they are better than you, but because they have the honor and privilege of serving you. I understand that magazine to be telling Nigerians that if we had erred by denying you the information that you need, the time is now that we are going to walk with you. I understand that magazine to be telling Nigerians that we recognize that we may not perform as we ought to have performed, but going forward, we are going to work with you. I understand that magazine to be saying that if we have starved you of information, we are going to ensure that you no longer starve of information. I understand that magazine to be a medium where the leaders of the House of Representatives in Nigeria are going to tell Nigerians that we may have erred when you gave us the honor and privilege of serving you, but we are going to be transparent and accountable. We are going to work with you. I understand that magazine to be saying that we are going to ensure that Nigerians walk with their leaders in the path of ensuring that Nigeria realizes our potential.